There's a bright golden haze on the meadow. There's a bright golden haze on the meadow. The corn is as high as a elephant's eye, and it looks like it's climbing clear up to the sky.
Buggy with red wheels onto it, have you? No, I ain't.
A spanking team with the rattles all jingling?
No.
Expect me to ride on behind old Dunn, I guess. You better go ask little Cummins girl you took such a shine to.
If I was to ask you, there'd be a way to take you, Miss Laura Smarty.
Oh, there would?
When I take you out tonight with me,
I'm not afraid to
There's a whole crowd of folks coming over from Bushyhead for the Bach Social.
Well,
sure I would, if he'd asked me.
Got to talking about other things. I'll go hitch up them horses now, if you say it's all right.
Sure.
Hey, look at it!
Howdy, fellers!
Hi, Will!
Hi, Ann Eller!
How'd you do at the fair? You do any good in the steer roping?
Oh, I did pretty good. I won it.
Ain't nobody can sling a rope like our territory, boys.
Can't stay but a minute, Ann Eller. I gotta get over to 80 Annie's. Don't you remember her pa said if I was ever worth $50, I could have her?
$50? That what they give you for prize money?
That's what.
Lads, if Annie's pa keeps his promise,
we'll be dancing at your wedding.
And if he don't keep his promise, I'll take her from right under his nose, and I won't bring him to prison I brought for him. Look at here, fellers, what I got for 80 Annie's pa. Excuse us, Ann Eller. See, you just hold it up to your eyes like this, and once you get a good look at it, you turn it at the top, and the picture changes.
Well, I'll be fine, baby.
They call it the little wonder.
So it goes. The hussy! Ought to be ashamed of herself. You too. How would you turn it to the other picture? Oh, I'm a lot to tell Annie on you.
Please don't, Ann Eller. She wouldn't understand.
Don't tell her what you went up to. Bet you carried on plenty in Kansas City.
Well, I wouldn't exactly call it carrying on, but I sure did see some things I'd never seen before. I got to Kansas City on a Friday.
What next?
What next? I gotta get over to Ada Wanny's. I got $50.
Well, time we get to talk with you boys. Thanks for loaning the wagon, Aunt Ella. Come on, Curly.
I'll catch up with you. Say, Aunt Ella, I gotta know something. Who's the
low, filthy sneaking Laura's got a cap set for?
You.
Never mind that. Sure, there's plenty of fellas trying to spark her. Surely she means to one of them now, don't she?
Well, there's that fine farmer, Jace Hutchins, just this side of Lonella. And then there's that litter man up from Claremore who makes himself out to be a doctor or veterinary.
That's what I thought. Hello, Jed.
Hello yourself.
And then there's someone a little closer to home that has her on his mind most of the time, till he don't know a plow from a threshing machine.
Him?
Jed Fry.
That bullet-colored growly man?
Don't you say nothing against him. He's just about the best hired hand I ever had. About runs this farm by himself. Well, two women could do it. You ought to know that.
Laura take up with a man like that.
I ain't said she's took up with him.
Well, he's around all the time, ain't he? Lives here.
Out in the old smokehouse.
Ain't gonna clean the henhouse today, Aunt Ella. I gotta leave it till tomorrow. I quit early. I'm driving Laurie over to the potty tonight.
You're driving Laurie?
Ask her.
Well, then that just make you bald. Remember, Aunt Ella, you and me's got a date tonight. If you make up a nice box lunch, maybe I bid for it.
Well, how we going, Curly? In that rig you made up? I'll ride a straddle and then lights are winking like lightning bugs.
That there ain't no made-up rig. I hired it over Claremore.
Yes, you did?
Sure did. Pretty one, too. When I come a-calling for you right after supper, see if you got your beauty spots fastened on your problems. You don't lose them up, you hear? That's right, smart sir, now. The wheels are yellow, the upholstery's brown, the dashboard's genuine leather.
You been riding a piece?
The Peatherman's gonna take me to the box social. I'm
ain't you?
Not what she might say promised. I just told the baby.
Well, don't you like him no more?
Of course I do. There ain't nobody like Will.
Then what about this Peppa man?
Well,
well, which one of them do you like the best?
Whichever one of them!
matter what.
Myself, but I sure do like to look at them. maybe I'll find you something to eat and drink.
Well, ask him, why don't you?
Alex, me and Laura have been having an argument.
Oh, about what, baby?
About what you meant when you said about us traveling to the end of the world.
Well, didn't really mean to the end of the world.
Well, then how far did you want to go?
Oh, about as far as, say, Claremont, to the hotel.
Well, what's at the hotel?
Outside of the hotel is a veranda. Inside is a lobby. Upstairs might just be paradise.
I thought they was just bedrooms.
But for you and me, baby, paradise.
Who is healthy and strong?
Okie doke.
I'm sure sorry to see you so happy. What I gotta say will make you miserable. I gotta marry Will!
That's, that's sad news for me, but, well, he is a fine fellow.
No chance.
All right. My heart is busted in two.
Oh, Alan, you do make up pretty things to say.
Thank you, Reddy.
Hello, Pop. What you been shooting?
Rabbits. That true what I hear about Will Parker getting $50?
That's right. And he wants to hold you to your promise.
Yeah, too bad. Still, no, can't go back on the word.
See,
I advise you to get that money off him before he loses it all. Stick it in your stocking or inside your corset where he can't get at it. Or can he?
Oh, he ain't exactly kept it. He spent it all on presents.
See? What did I tell you? Now he can't get it. I said it had to be $50 cash.
But Mr. Cox, is that fair?
Who the hell are you? Face, or I'll fill your behind so full of lead you'll be walking around like a duck for the rest of your life.
Allie, if I don't have to marry Will, maybe your heart don't have to be busted into two like you said.
I did not say that.
Oh, yes, you did.
No, I did not.
You trying to make my daughter out to be a liar?
No, I'm making clear what the liar I am if she is telling the truth.
What else you been saying to my daughter?
Oh, an awful lot.
When?
Last night in the moonlight.
Where?
Next to a haystack.
Listen, Mr. Cons.
I'm listening. What else have you been saying?
He called me his Persian kitten.
What'd you call her that for?
I don't remember.
I do. He said I was like his Persian kitten, because they was the cats with the soft round tails.
I'm no good. I'm a peddler. Peddler travels up and down and all around, and you hardly ever see your daughter no more.
Oh, that's all right. Take good care of her, son. Take care of my little rose bud.
Oh, Paul, that's pretty. You sure for certain you can bear to let me go?
Are you sure, Mr. Carter?
Just try and change my mind. See what happens to you.
Oh, Allie, ain't it wonderful? Paul making up my mind for us. He won't change, neither. Why, once he gives his word that you can have it, why, you got me!
I know, I got you.
Drink from a jug! I'm a happy man! talking to a certain farmer's daughter than I'm looking in the muzzle of a gun.
Don't laugh.
think I'll go down to the old smokehouse where Judd's at and see what's so elegant about him that makes girls want to go to parties with him.
Curly!
What?
Nothing!
Let's get you die first.
I guess it's so.
They sure would sing loud when the singing started. They sing like their hearts would break.
Farm down by Sweetwater?
Oh, sure do. terrible accident about 5 years ago. Burnt the father, the mother, and the daughter.
It weren't no accident. The fella that told me said that the hired hand was sweet on the body girl, and he found it in a hayloft with another fella.
And it was him that burnt the place?
Took him weeks to get all the kerosene, buying it at different times. The fella that told me made out like it happened over in Missouri, but I know the whole time it was the body that found. What a lie he was.
Kind of a murderer too, wouldn't he? Get some air in here.
You ain't told me yet what business you got down here, Colonel. You got no cattle and no cowponies. And the old crop's done spoke for.
Sure leave my mind considerable.
There's only one other thing on this farm you could want. And it better not be that.
But that's just what it is.
It better not be. You stay away from her, Curly.
You know, somebody ought to tell Laurie about the kind of man you are. For that matter, somebody ought to tell you once about yourself.
You better get out of here, Curly.
Fella wouldn't feel very safe in here with you if he didn't know you. But I know you, Judd. In this country, there's two things you can do if you're a man. Live out of doors is one, and live in a hole is the other. I've set my horse in the brush somewhere, heard a rattlesnake go by many a time. Rattle, rattle, rattle. He'd go scared to death. Somebody come close to his hole. Somebody gonna step on him, get his old fangs full of poison, and curl up and wait. Long as you live in a hole, you're scared. You got to have protection. You can have muscles like iron and still be as weak as an empty bladder. Unless you got things you bargain or hide with. How'd you get to be the way you are anyway? Sitting in this here filthy hole and thinking the way you're thinking. Why don't you do something healthy once in a while instead of staying shut up in here or crawling in a vestry? You ought to feel better. A little hard on the roof, though. Wish you'd let me show you something. It's a knothole over there, size of a diamond. See the winkling? I just want to see if I can hit it. Bullet right through without catching. Slick as a whistle, didn't I? I know I can do it. You saw it too, didn't you? Someone's coming, I expect.
You fired a gun. Is that you, Curly? Answer when you're spoke to, you lummy!
Well, I shot once.
Well, what was you shooting at?
See that knothole over there?
I see a lot of knotholes.
Well, it was one of them.
Weren't you a pair of pretty nothings? I shooting at knotholes and scaring everybody to death. I ought to give you a good Dutch rub and iron all the craziness out of you. It's all right, nobody's hurt. Just a pair of fools swapping noises.
Mind if I visit with you, gents? Good to get away from the women for a while. Now, we're all by ourselves. I got a few private knickknacks for to show you. Special for the men folk.
I'll see you, gentlemen, later. Gotta go get a surrey I hired up for tonight.
Our postcards.
Who you think you're taking in that surrey?
Aaron Ellen. And Laurie, if she'll go with me.
She won't.
Maybe she will.
She promised to go with me, Curly, and she'd better not change her mind. She'd better not.
Now, I want you to look at these, straight from Paris.
Don't want none. You got any frog stickers?
You mean one of them long knives? What would you want with a thing like that?
Who know, kill a hog or a skunk? What difference does it make? See, what I'd really like to have if you got one. You ever hear one of them things they call the little wonder? It's a thing you look through, you know, to see pictures. Only that ain't all it is, not quite. You see, it's got a little jig on the other side of it, and when you touch it, sharp blade springs out.
On a spring, huh?
You say to a tenant, here, look through this. And when he's looking through it, you snap out the blade, and he's just above his chest. And you burn him! Damn, you come with it.
Oh. Thank you.